Attention business owners and managers. Are you determined to make 2019 your best year yet? Are you tired of not showing up online where people are searching? Are you overwhelmed by digital marketing? If you answered yes to these, stop. Write this down and after the podcast, get help. Go to successfulmarketinggroup.com/Cheryl Reeve. Glory Ramsey and Successful Marketing Group will help you get found, get customers, and build your dreams. Her results are proof. After the podcast, go to successfulmarketinggroup.com/Cheryl Reeve and sign up for a free 45-minute phone call and action plan with Glory. Make 2019 a huge success.
We have news. Sometimes this podcast is philosophical. Sometimes it's goofy. This time we actually have a lot to get to. The Lynx are making news. We have Cheryl Reeve, general manager and coach of the Minnesota Lynx, with us. Of course, it's her podcast, part of the TalkNorth.com podcast network. Thanks to our producer, Brandon Morton. Please download before you listen. Follow us at TalkNorthPod on Twitter. And if you'd like to advertise with us, you can reach us at TalkNorthPodcast@gmail.com. Thanks to our current sponsors, SuccessfulMarketingGroup.com. That's Cheryl, Gloria Ramsey's company, and Shelley being the sports queen. If you're interested in Glory's services, and she can help you get found, especially on the internet, go to successfulmarketinggroup.com/Cheryl Reeve and sign up for a free 45-minute action plan. And Shelley being the sports queen, Shelley Boyan-Breen, who's the author and our friend, has been encouraging me to talk about the and let me get the name right. And of course, I always hit the wrong button as soon as I start talking about things. The National Girls and Women in Sports Day, which is happening in early February. So later on, I'll ask Cheryl about maybe one of the more influential women in her life. I've asked Roy Smalley and other people across the podcast network and gotten some cool answers. And because of National Girls and Women in Sports Day, if you go to ShelleyBeingTheSportsQueen.com and enter the promo code NGWSD, you'll get 33% off cover price on her books. We'll tell you more about those things in a minute. So you re-sign Simone Augustus. You sign, is it Charima?
Karima.
Thank you. Karima Christmas Kelly, who a very versatile player and excellent defender. Well, but I'll let you tell us about it. Tell us about both signings
no,
if you want.
Keep going. I wanted to hear.
No, I'd like the expert opinion on this.
Well, obviously, you know, the Simone Augustus signing is one that I think people thought was a foregone conclusion, but I think, you know, this is the first time that Simone Augustus has experienced free agency. She's never been a free agent in her entire career. Simone has always been someone who, you know, once she completed her rookie contract, she agreed to an extension, and she's always been down for being here in Minnesota with the Minnesota Lynx and with this franchise. And so this was the first time, you know, we made a decision before the start of last year that we had been extending all of these players for all these years, that we thought it was time to give ourselves a little more flexibility as we went into the off season. And with that goes, you know, the danger of, you know, maybe these players that, you know, you get courted by the teams, that maybe they see something and another franchise that could lure them. You know, Renee Montgomery was lured last offseason, you know, by Atlanta, you know, with the promise of a starting job and you know, a little bit more money. So you just never know. And so we took nothing for granted with Simone. We spent a lot of time with her. We talked with her about what we saw going forward, and of course told her how important she has been and the significance of her loyalty, which you just don't see anymore, and not just pro sports. You don't see it in college sports. You know, there's transfers all over the place. And so, you know, Simone has been here since 2006. I first told her that wasn't lost on us, and how much we appreciate the thrills that she's given us through her years, and that we wanted to keep going. We wanted to continue to have her a part of this. And thankfully, she agreed to that, and we courted her a little bit, which was, you know, I think probably awkward for Simone, because you're like, what are you doing, coach? Because, like, we've known each other for a long, long time. So that part was fun for me. I don't know how fun it was for Simone. But and then you mentioned the newcomer, Karima Christmas Kelly, who, you know, there's been a couple of years that Charima was available until January 14th when the core tag eliminated her from consideration in free agency. And so this was the first year over the last couple that she was not cored by Dallas. Dallas also had another free agent that was unrestricted that they decided to use the core tag, core designation on Glory Johnson. And so that freed up Charima Christmas Kelly to us. And, we're so lucky. We have such a great group of players that kind of, you know, they want to be involved in the process and they wanted to meet, you know, Charima. They wanted to have her here. So we brought her to Minneapolis and she got to experience a fun Wolves game, Wolves San Antonio, spent time with our owner and, you know, Glenn and Becky and spent time with the players. And, you know, it was a quick trip, but thankfully it was before the polar vortex. We were able to show her a good time. And ultimately we were able to win the battle against four or five other teams for Charima services. So we're excited about that. Charima is somebody, you know, they want to know basketball wise. You know, those of you that have watched, you know that Charima gives us a physical presence, both offensively and defensively. The defensive side of it is obvious. She's very difficult to play against. She has length. She has intelligence in the way that she defends. Just has a fortitude about her that I really enjoy. One of her all-time greatest plays in the history of the WNBA for her was a block that she had on Sylvia Fowles. I know Sylvia will love me putting this on blast, but we were down in Dallas, and some of you have to go back and try to find that clip. It was unbelievable play, because Syl's not easy to play against. But anyway, not the reason for the sole reason for the signing, but just memorable for us. And then offensively, the physical way that she plays in getting to the basket. If you look at our group, you know, if you pair her next to some of the players that we have, like that doesn't necessarily get to the foul line as much. She's more of a, you know, pull up jumper. She'll shoot the three. She might get in there for a floater, but, you know, not a physical way of attacking the rim. Charima has that. We think that's important. And she also has the ability to shoot the three. She was at a 40% clip before she was injured last year. We're going to have to try to make sure that we can kind of keep her, you know, in that range. It's going to be important to us that we, you know, we have 3-point shooting. So that was, you know, the summary of those two signings.
How do you court someone you've known for so long or have a relationship with? I mean, you're talking about, you take her out to dinner, you just send her cards, texts. What do you do?
You got to get creative, as you know. It's a, you know, I think when you're together for so long, you can sort of, you know, forget or, you know, maybe not bring to the forefront as much all the things that you enjoy about a person. And I think when this free agency thing came front and center, you know, you have this opportunity to kind of remember all those things. And, you know, you just, you know, it's definitely conversation. It was definitely, we've spent, Simone's been here in Minneapolis a couple times. She was here rehabbing and then she left and then we fly her in, a little bit to, you know, in the off season, just to kind of keep her going. And we went to lunch a couple times. We sat down at the opening of free agency. And I made sure, I told her, I said, look, there's going to be a lot of free agency talk. There's going to be a lot of talk about our franchise, a lot of talk about other free agents. I want you to know how important you are before this thing starts. Told her there would be some other players we would be courting, but none were more important than her. So that sort of thing. And then obviously, you know, just the, you know, you tell her how much you appreciate, how thankful you are that, that she was so loyal through all those years. Like I mentioned, that wasn't lost on us. And then we did a little something. I'll let Simone tell you when she gets back to Minneapolis. We did a little something for her when she was down in Baton Rouge that I got an absolute kick out of. So I hope she'll want to tell the story. But it's it was something that, you know, and with Mone, it's got to be something fun. You can't be serious all the time. So you have a nice conversation that's serious, but you got to have some fun. And so there was a follow up that we had some fun with her.
I have a follow-up question of my own about Simone and kind of her career arc and maybe how her personality has changed over the years, at least from outside perception. Do want to thank Glory Ramsey, SuccessfulMarketingGroup.com. Again, the promo code you want to know is SuccessfulMarketingGroup.com/Cheryl Reeve. She can help you show up on page one for multiple searches. She can help businesses of all kinds, dentists, medical spas, plastic surgeons, heating and cooling companies, auto repair companies, whatever you want. And she's an expert at this stuff. She's a good writer. She understands language, how to attract people with language. And she can you know, she can do it at a lower price than the big agencies because she has, it runs a very lean operation. SuccessfulMarketingGroup.com/Cheryl Reeve. So I remember seeing Simone play at the University of Minnesota when she was with LSU, and she was a spectacular college player. She's been a Team USA player for a very long time. She's won championships with you. And from my limited, obviously, perspective, being outside your franchise, to me, she's become even a better and more fun personality as time has gone on. Have you seen that, or has she always been the same with you guys?
You know, I think I've seen that, you know, since 2010. I remember, you know, kind of being told that, you know, Simone is just low key, doesn't want a bunch of attention and that sort of thing. And, you know, and that's, you know, when it's the face of your franchise, you know, you probably prefer that maybe she want to put herself out there a little bit more and be more engaging, you know, for the media. And, I think that our group, as we got together, I think Simone kind of grew into that. I know when Maya, when we drafted Maya in 2011, I remember the feeling that Simone and Lindsay and maybe Rebecca Brunson a little bit, as they were coming into their own as leaders and becoming the real voices, they weren't quite there yet. You know, there was some talk about, like, for Simone, hey, you probably should go somewhere else. Here comes Maya Moore. You know, you're not going to get the attention, that sort of thing. And Simone, I remember Simone being like, no, we want Maya. I want Maya. I want the help. And Maya's like Mikey when it comes to the media. Remember this, the life cereal with Mikey, you know, give it to Mikey, he'll eat it. He eats anything. Well, that's how they viewed Maya with the media. You know, Maya was like this young gun that, you know, got all this attention coming out of UConn and, you know, with ESPN right there in Connecticut. And, you know, she was the media darling. And I remember Simone being thrilled. You know, go ahead, Maya, you can have all of that attention. And then we just worked with her through the years, and just, I think she's made the realization, you know, it's maturity too, that, you know, people get to know you through those experiences, whether it's your, you know, media exchanges, interviews, or whether it's, you know, podcasts or appearances or whatever it is that you do. And I think that, you know, Simone is now, if you notice, she's far more active on social media and putting her workouts out there and just kind of doing things more that, she's far more aware. I think that's probably true for all of us. You know, I think the digital media age has, you know, kind of improved all of our abilities to kind of share who we are and what we're about. And I think Simone has done that. Simone is hilarious. I think somebody asked me recently, would Simone sort of be going to be the den mother of the group? And I laughed pretty hard. And I thought there was nothing den mother about Simone Augustus. Simone is the Pied Piper. Everyone loves Simone, and Simone is able to kind of, you know, you kind of judge a book by the by its cover. That, you know, you go, you think what Simone might be attracted to in terms of relationships. I don't mean personal relationships. I just mean where she might engage her time. And through the years, I have been just blown away about places that Simone can put herself in and become great friends with certain people on the team that we probably would never put together, because Simone is just, she's just has that way that no matter who she's with, she engages in a way that you just love Simone. She's hilarious. Obviously, she's talented. You know, that goes without saying. But the other part is what makes it really fun, who she is in the locker room. You know, she brings levity to situations. And Simone doesn't want it ever to feel like work or too serious. Now, we've had some very serious moments along the way, meaning competing at a high level, championship games, game fives, closing seconds, that sort of thing. I'm not talking about, you know, Simone wants to be, you know, in that heat of the moment. And when Mone gets her dreads popping and gets excited, those are my most favorite times with Simone, because she's having fun. And it's my job to ensure that Simone continues to have fun all the way through the end of her career.
You know, one thing, I have a thought on women's sports and the way in which, you know, women have to promote women's sports. Do want to thank Shelley Bean, sportsqueen.com, sportsbooks. Again, the promo code that you want to use for 33% off her books right now is NGWSD, National Girls and Women's Sports Day. NGWSD, that's 33% off the cover price in honor of the 33rd anniversary of that event. And if you haven't heard us talk about Shelley before, Shelley Bean, the Sports Queen, is a book series for ages 4 through 9 about a tough little girl who loves to learn new sports. It isn't easy for her, but each time she gets back up and tries demonstrating perseverance to girls and boys of all ages. And don't just take it from me, don't just take it from Shelley. Book reviewer Rebecca Flansburg said, I love